2021 makeup trends. Sheer foundation. Lifted eyes with concealer. Sun-kissed blush a lot. Natural brows fluffy. Bronzer for eyeshadow. Brown shadow for wings. Half lashes. Overlined lips. Gloss always. What do you think?
Hi everyone, welcome back. If you're new here, my name is Smitha. Welcome to my channel. Over the years, we've seen so many changes when it comes to makeup and makeup trends. And of course, we have one for 2021 as well. So in today's tutorial, I'm going to be showing you what people are wearing in 2021. What kind of makeup do they apply so you can stay on top of your game? So if you're ready, let's begin. We, of course, will be starting with skin prep, and I'm going to apply my favorite eye cream. This is the Tatcha Silk Peony. And when it comes to eye cream or applying anything around the eyes, yes, you have to use your ring finger because that applies the least pressure. But if you're like me and if you don't have much strength in your ring finger, you can use another finger, but just be very gentle. I'm giving myself a good massage before I move on to hydrating my lips. And for that, I'm going to be using the Rose Lip Balm by Milani. Again, one of my favorites. For primer, I'm going to be using the Laura Mercier Pure Canvas Primer. Now, they have different types in this. The one that I'm using is the Perfecting Primer, and this is silicone free. This most definitely gives a beautiful hydrating glow, and it perfects the skin and keeps the canvas looking flawless for whatever you apply over this. It's infused with vitamin C, green tea extract, as well as aloe vera gel, so it calms and soothes your skin as well. I love it when I don't feel the makeup or skincare on my face and it feels super lightweight, and that's precisely what it feels like when you apply this primer. Speaking of which, we don't want to layer too much, so I'm going to be using a very light peach corrector from the Coastal Scents Concealed Palette and lightly color correct under my eyes and around my mouth. And because I'm using a very light peach corrector, I'm not even going to bother to set it with any powder. I'm just going to move on to the foundation. Rather than using a heavy foundation, I'm going to be using the new Makeup Forever Water Tone Skin Perfecting Tint. The shade that I'm using is Desert, which is Y365, and to apply it, I'm using a foundation brush. What this really does is it's not your typical foundation giving you extreme coverage. Instead, it gives you that clean, sheer skin tint that minimizes imperfections and gives you that beautiful complexion. Although it doesn't give you the typical foundation coverage, it still covers the imperfections. You guys know that I have a lot of hyperpigmentation and redness on my face, and you can see the way it has covered it. You can still see through and still see the dark spots and the uneven skin tone, but it kind of evens everything out, so your skin will still look like skin, but a more balanced, more even looking skin. And this is something that I've been using on an everyday basis when I run to the grocery store or I have some chores to do, or even for business meetings. I just apply this. I apply a light layer and it looks really fresh and nice. Gone are the days when we used to apply the concealer in a V shape under our eye. Now we just focus on areas where it needs to be covered. The darkest areas in a dark circle is usually in the corners, and that's where we will use the concealer, and I'm using very little. I'm going to blend it out with a damp sponge, and whatever residue is left on the sponge, I'm going to use it on my lids to even out the skin. What's also big and trending in 2021 is a sun-kissed blush, and a lot of it. I'm going to be using a liquid blush to get that natural flush on my skin. And the one that I'll be using is the Rare Beauty Blush in Love. If you've used these blushes, you already know that they are highly pigmented. So I'm going to use very little on the highest planes of my cheeks and blend it out with a kabuki brush. If I need more, I can always add to this. And then whatever residue is left on the brush, I'm going to be using it in the center of the bridge of my nose just to get that sunburnt look. When it comes to setting the face with powder, again, we'll stay true to the theme of keeping everything minimum. Just taking a little bit with a foundation brush, dusting off the excess, and I'm going to set in two areas. One is the T-zone because I sweat in my T-zone, and second in areas where I applied the concealer because we don't want the concealer to crease. And then to set the base makeup and to lock everything in, I'm going to be using my favorite setting spray. This is the Benefit Super Setter. This mist, if you haven't tried it, I haven't seen anything like this. The mist is so fine. It doesn't feel like anything on your face, but it sets it. Let's move on to the brows. The key is to keep it natural looking and fluffy and feathery. So I'm going to be not filling on top, and I'm only going to be filling the lower part of my brows because I already have thick brows. All I need to do now is just fill in the sparse areas and feather it out. And for that, I'm going to be using the Precisely My Brow from Benefit. Again, my favorite brow pencil, and this is in the shade 4.5. We all know that the foxy eye has been trending for quite some time, and we use a lot of neutral browns in creating foxy eye. And in 2021, for whatever reason, rather than using eyeshadows, we've ditched the eyeshadows and just used a bronzer. I'm going to be using the Hoola bronzer. This is from Benefit Cosmetics and it's pretty pigmented. I'm going to mostly focus this in the very outer corner, and part of creating that foxy eye look is to make your eyes look more elongated. And the way you're going to do that is use the eyeshadow in the very outer corner and almost push it out. So when you push it out, it creates that shadow and it gives you that elongated eye look. And then with a flat shader brush, I'm also going to smoke it out in my lower lash line. Rather than using a black eyeliner, which is common and sometimes can look harsh, the trend is to use a lighter shade like a brown or a cool gray, and to create a softer winged liner. I'm just using a brown eyeshadow from the Rosé in the Air palette by Wet n Wild, and I'm going to line my top lash line as well as pull out a small wing in the outer corner and the inner corner. And that gives a very soft smoked out liner look, and I'm going to finish up with some lashes, but before that I'm using mascara. And while applying mascara, I'm almost pushing my lashes also outward and upward to get that elongated eye look. You can stop at this if you like. You don't have to use lashes. But today I'm going to be using the Tati lashes. All the products are listed down below in the description box. Rather than using the entire strip, I'm going to cut it into half. And I'm going to be using the inner half in the outer corner. And that again adds to that elongated foxy eye look. And here is the completed eye makeup. And all I'm going to do to finish up this entire look is to use a light lip tint just to enhance my lip color and lots of lip gloss. But before that, I'm going to start with a lip pencil in the borders. I'm just using a brown lip pencil by Jordana, listed down below in the description box. For lip tint, I'm going to be using the ColourPop tint in Give Me Some More. This is a very light tint. All it adds is a little bit of tint and a lot of shine. On top of this, I'm going to use the beautiful Glow Gloss by Becca in Champagne Cream. I fixed my hair, and this was recorded before my haircut, so my hair is still long in this. And here is the completed look. If you've been following me for a while, you know that I absolutely embrace beautiful natural looks, not too much makeup, and something that makes your skin look healthier. And I believe that's where the industry is moving. I can see that trend. What about you? What kind of makeup do you like? Let me know in the comment section below. And if you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to give me a thumbs up. And if you're new here, please consider subscribing. I post several times a week, and listed down below are all the products that I used as well as my social media links in case you plan to follow me there. I love you guys so much, and I will see you soon with a brand new one. Bye guys.